In this lesson, we will learn to conduct a harmonic analysis study. So the data from the harmonic analysis study is useful for filter designing. So in order to start with, I will add a nonlinear load to my existing single line diagram. And let me see. Yeah, the static load over here. And I will connect it to my bus over here. Then I will rate this for 2 MVA. And the power factor will be at 85%. And I will click on OK. Before going anywhere else, I will go to the harmonic page over here. Then I will go to the library and select one current source. So I will select the fluorescent current source over here. We have the waveform and the spectrum over here. So I will select these. Then I will conduct a load flow study over here. So going to the load flow analysis. Okay, everything is fine. Then we will switch over to the harmonic analysis mode over here. And this appears over here. Just close this over here. Then let me run the harmonic analysis over here. It will ask for a file name. Then I will click on OK. Then go to the edit study case again and go to the plot options and plot my bus 3. Then the harmonic slider appears again, so I'll close this and again run this and go to my display options. Okay, this is the fundamental harmonic or the first harmonic, which is occurring at 60 hertz. So this is about 10.92 kilovolt. And the total harmonic distortion is given in percentage, is about 0.78%. And when I slide the harmonic order, so this is the first harmonic, that is about 10.92, and there is no third harmonic, and the fifth harmonic is 0.07 kV, and this is the seventh harmonic. So since the harmonic value is below the specified limits, I will go and change the loading to make it more significant. So I will go to the 10 MVA load and again running this. Okay, this straightforward puts me in the critical window over here. So as you can see, all the buses are exceeding the harmonic levels over here. So the rating limits are 1.5, but these are operating about 2.91. And let me close this. And now the total harmonic distortion is 3.45%, and the third harmonic is absent, fifth harmonic is 0.31. okay, now let's go to plot over here. Then I will select the waveform and the spectrum for the bus 3. So as you can see, the fifth order harmonic magnitude is about 2.8. So the magnitude is about 2.8, and here this is about 1.8. Seventh harmonic is about 1.8. So this is the distorted waveform over here. And next I want to show you is the frequency scan. So running the frequency scan, again we go to the alert window over here. Let me close this over here. So this system is operating at 60 hertz fundamental frequency. So 60 hertz fundamental frequency, we have about 0.79 ohm, that is the impedance towards this frequency. Now if I change the frequency over here, you can see the impedance value changes accordingly. And this is one of the reasons where the higher order harmonics have lower amplitudes. So we can have this over here. We can go to the plot options and go to the frequency scan. Then I will plot for the bus 3 over here. So this is the impedance angle, as you can see the impedance angle, and over here this is the magnitude of the impedance towards the harmonic orders. So let me change this from the harmonic order to the frequency. So let me change this to the frequency. With respect to the frequency, I will go this over here and select this, select the bus device, okay. Then and this gives the angle with respect to the frequency. So as you can see in the magnitude plot, there is a reduction in the impedance at this frequency over here, which is about 4000 hertz, and as you can see right about here we have low impedance, which is the impedance for the fundamental harmonic. And this is how you conduct a harmonic analysis in ETAP. And in the next lesson, we will learn to size a harmonic filter to mitigate the problems caused by harmonics.